What were you asking me again?
When you touch these.
Oh, when I touch these, like this, I'm not getting shocked. You're like, what the heck? You'll note that I'm not touching it with my ring that I shouldn't be wearing, because the problem is, even though this is at 52 volts, it's not enough to overcome the resistance of my hand. So if my hand was made of metal, it would overcome the resistance and I would get really hot. This will blow you away. So if I grab my meter probes from here and I plug it into my multimeter and measure the resistance, and then touch the end of these probes, you will actually be able to measure the resistance of me. If I touch it, one in the left hand, one in the right hand, you can see I'm 2.2 megohms. What's really funny is as I move, this actually changes. It like jumps up. You see how it's like 2.5? What's actually happening is there is a very, very small voltage coming through this meter and actually passing through my body. And based on how much that voltage drops, that's how this is determining what the resistance is. We can even plug our multimeter into another multimeter and measure what that voltage is. You can see it's about 1.8 volts. We can also measure the input resistance of the multimeter at 10 megohms. There's a million different factors that go into it, but here's what you got to know that is the critical piece. It takes 5 milliamps, that's 5/1000ths of an amp, to kill you, like stop your heart, that kind of thing, right? But it takes enough voltage across your body to pass enough current to actually cause harm. It's not just the volts that kill you. You can have high voltage, low current, and be fine. And it's not the amps that kill you, because I have a lot of amps available here at these terminals, but there's not enough voltage to drive it across my body. So it takes both of them to actually be dangerous. Now, that being said, when there's high current available, and things like metal rings, I could easily get burned on that. And that's a bigger risk at low voltage than getting electrocuted to death. So it's definitely a good idea to take your rings off and, keep them from shorting out on things if you want to stay safe.